Jaya Krishna, Jaya Vrindavan.
Radhe, Jaya Krishna, Jaya Vrindavan.
Jaya Radhe, Jaya Krishna, Jaya Vrindavan.
Jaya Hare, Jaya Krishna, Jaya Vrindavan.
Shri Govinda Gopinath Madana Mohan. Shri Govinda Gopinath Madana Kunda, Radha Kunda, Giri Govardhan. Jaya, Jaya Mahavan. Kalindi Yamuna Jaya, Jaya Mahavan. Vamsi Bata Dvadasakana Krisi Gata Vamsi Bata Dvadasakana. Balila Koilo Shri Nanda Nanda Yahasa Balila Koilo Shri Nanda Nanda Yasoda Jaya, Jaya Gopaga. Shri Nanda. यशोधा जाया जय गोपागान श्री रमादि जाया जाया दिन वसागा jaya jaya dhinu vasagha jaya vrishabhanu jaya kirti da sundari Shabhanu Jaya Kirti Ja Sundari
Jaya Shabhanu Jaya Kirti
Ja Sundari Jaya Purnamasi Jaya Abhira Nagari Jaya Purnamasi Jaya Abhira Nagari
Jaya Purnamasi Jaya Abhira Nagari
Jaya Jaya Gopishwara Vrindavana Ma
Jaya Jaya Gopishwara Vrindavana Ma
Jaya Jaya Gopishwara Vrindavana Ma Jaya Krishna Sakha Bhatu Dvijara
Jaya 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 Rama Ghata Jaya Rohini Nanda Jaya Vrindavan Vasujata Jan जय वृंदावन वसिष्ठा जहां
जय जय वृंदावन वसिष्ठा
जहां जय द्विज पत्नी जय नागकन्या
जय
जय द्विज पत्नी जय नागकन्या बाकीते यहारा फैलो गोविंदाचारा बाकीते यहारा फैलो Ramandala Jaya Jaya Rasa Shyam Jaya Jaya Rasa Lila Sarva Manoraha
Jaya Jaya Rasa Lila Sarva
Manoraha Jaya Jaya Rasa Lila Sarva Manoraha Rajate Pracha Parakiya Bhaveya Rajate Pracha
Shri Ramana
gloria smaran. Krishna Dasa Kohe Namasankirtan.
Dina Krishna Dasa Kohe Namasankirtan.
Dina Krishna Dasa Kohe Namasankirtan.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
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 namaskrityam
narayanam namaskrityam
naram chaiva narottamam
naram chaiva narottamam
daivim sarasatim vyasam
devim sarasatim vyasam
tato jayamudhirayat
tato jayamudhirayat
Prayeshu Vabhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 3 Text number 17.
今天我们阅读《圣莲波迦瓦坛》第一篇第三章第十七节。
Danvantaram,
Danvantaram,
Tvadashamam,
Tvadashamam,
Trayodashamam.
Triyodasamam
Evacha
Evacha
Apayayat
Apayayat
Suran
Suran
Anyan
Anyan
Mohinya
Mohinya
Mohayan
Mohayan
Shtriya
Shtriya
Danvantaram Dvadashamam
Danvantaram Dvadashamam
Trayodashamam evacha
Trayodashama evacha
Apayayatsuran anyan
Apayayatsuran anyan
Mohinya mohayan shtriya
Mohinya mohayan shtriya
Danvantaram dvadashamamTrayodashamam evacha
Trayodashama evacha
Apayayatsuran anyan
Apayayatsuran anyan
Mohinya mohayan shtriya
Mohinya mohayan shtriya Devantara dvadashamam
Danvantara dvadashamam
Trayodashama evacha
Trayodashama evacha
Apayayasuran anyan
Apayayasuran anyan
Mohinya mohayan shtriya
Mohinya mohayan shtriya
Davantaram dvadashama Anyang
Apayaya Suran Anyang
Mohinya Mohayan Yas Yastraya
Mohinya Mohayan Shriya
Damantaram Vidasama
Damantaram Vidasama
Trayo Dasama Evacha
Trayo Dasama
Trayodashamam evacha
Trayodashamam evacha
Anyone else?
还有吗？
Dhanvantaram,
Dhanvantaram,
the incarnation of Godhead named Dhanvantari.
Incarnation,
名叫 Dhanvantari 的守神化身。
Dvadashamam,
Dvadashamam,
the 12th in the line.
The 12th in the line, 第十二位。
Trayodashamam,
Trayodashamam,
the 13th in the line.
The 13th in the line, 第十三位。
Eva,
Eva,
certainly,
certainly, 肯定的。
Cha,
Cha,
and,
和。
Apayayat,
Apayayat,
give to drink,
give to drink, 给什么给谁谁喝。
Suran,
Suran,
the demigod,
demigod, 半神人
Anyan,
Anyan,
others,
others, 其他人
Mohinya,
Mohinya,
by charming beauty,
by charming beauty,
以迷人的美丽
Mohayan,
Mohayan,
alluring,
alluring, 诱惑
Shriya,
Shriya,
in the form of a woman,
in the form of a woman,
以女人的形象。
Translation. In the 12th incarnation, the Lord appeared as Dhanvantari, and in the 13th, he allured the atheists by the charming beauty of a woman and gave nectar to the demigods to drink.
译文：至尊主显现的第十二位化身是 Dhanvantari， 他以他第十三位化身那富有魅力的美女形象诱惑无神论者，把甘露给了半神人喝。
There's no purport.
这个没有要旨。
We'll go on to text 18.
我们继续第十八节。
Chaturdasham Narasimham.
Narasimham.
Bibradaijendram Urjitam
Bibradaijendra Urjitam
Dadara Karajer Ura
Dadara Karajer Ura
Irakam Katakridyata
Irakam Katakridyata
In the 14th incarnation, the Lord appeared as Narsimha.And bifurcated the strong body of the atheist Hiranyakashipu with his nails, just as a carpenter pierces cane.
至尊主的第十四位化身显现为尼星啊，用他的指甲撕开无神论者Hiranyakashipu强壮的身体，仿佛木匠劈竹子。
Again, there's no purport. We'll go on to.
又没有要旨，我们继续下一个。
Panchadasham Bhamanakam
Panchadasham Bhamanakam
Kridvagad Advarambale
Kridvagad Advarambale
Padatrayam Yachamana
Padatrayam Yachamana
Pratyaditsu Stripishtapam
Pratyaditsu Stripishtapam
In the 15th incarnation, the Lord assumed the form of a dwarf Brahmana, Vamana, and visited the arena of sacrifice arranged by Maharaj Bali. Although at heart he was willing to regain the kingdom of the three planetary systems, he simply asked for a donation of 3 steps of land.
祭文以第十五位化身显现时，至尊主扮作侏儒婆阿曼那瓦曼那，到巴利王安排的祭祀场去。他心里虽然想收回3个星系的王国，但表面上却只要求3部土地的布施。
Purport. The Almighty God can bestow upon anyone the kingdom of the universe from a very small beginning, and similarly he can take away the kingdom of the universe on the plea of begging a small piece of land.
女娲娃要旨，全能的神可以从小处开始赐予任何人以整个宇宙那么大的王国，同样他也可以从请求一小块土地开始拿走整个宇宙那么大的王国。
Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanena Tasmai Shri GuruveVanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa-sindhu-bhaibhacha Patitanam-pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo-namah Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaurakta Vinda Hare Krishna Hare KrishnaKrishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So the pastime of the appearance of Lord Vamanadeva is described in the 8th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛第八篇就描述了这个诸如巴曼那瓦曼那的消失光。
And it's described howThe demigods had, well, Indra had not taken care of his guru, Brihaspati, and Brihaspati left them.
就像半身人那以就以印度王为首的对他们的 guru Brihaspati 没有那么照顾，所以他的 guru 就离开了。
So when they lost their guru, they were in difficulty. They didn't have anybody to instruct them.
没有了失去了他们的guru，他们就处于困境当中，没有人能够指导他们，训斥他们。
But the demons, they had their guru. Their guru, the guru of the demons was Sukracharya.
而恶魔们，他们有他们的guru，他们的guru是 Sukracharya.
Sukracharya had, he told the demons about the importance of giving charity to the Brahmins.
而他的 guru 们呢，他这恶魔的 guru 给他们训示，强调这个给他人布施的重要性。
嗯 ，give the brahmanas
给婆罗门布施的重要性。
Yeah，so the demons took advantage of that。
所以恶魔们充分利用了这一点。
And they became very powerful。
所以恶魔们变得强大有力。
And because they were following the orders of their guru, they became very powerful。
因为他们追随了他们 guru 的训示，他们变得强大有力。
And so they attacked the demigods, and the demigods were driven out of their kingdom, the heavenly planet.
所以他们向半神人发起了进攻，把半神人们逐出了他们天堂的王国。
The demigods live in the higher planets, up in heaven.
这个半神人们曾居住在这个天堂星处。
And the demons, they live in the lower region of the universe.
而这个恶魔们居住在这个宇宙的低等的区域。
So.There's no sunlight in the bottom of the universe.
在地球宇宙的底部没有阳光。
Everything is lit by jewels.
他们的靠那个珠宝发光，照明。
So sometimes the demons, you know, they try to conquer the heavenly planet.
所以有的时候恶魔试图征服天堂星宿。
And usually the demigods will defeat them.
通常来说他们干不过半身人，半身能把他们击败。
But when they offended their guru Brihaspati, then the time went against them. They didn't have any good luck to defeat the demons.
但是呢，半身人一旦冒犯了他们的灵性导师 Brihaspati, 他们的时辰就发生变化，他们的好运就没了。
And so the demons took over the heavenly planet.
所以恶魔占领了天堂星球。
And the leader of the demons is Bali Maharaj.
恶魔的首领领袖是 Bali Maharaj.
Bali Maharaj is the grandson of Prahlad Maharaj.
Bali Maharaj 是 Prahlad Maharaj 的孙子。
Prahlad Maharaj was the son of Hiranyakashipu.
而 Prahlad 是 Hiranyakashipu 的儿子。
Hiranyakashipu was a big demon.
Hiranyakashipu 是个大恶魔。
Right, and so, Prahlad Maharaj, however, he was a great devotee.
那不知怎的那个，不管怎么说 ，Prahlad 是一位伟大的奉献者。
And Bali Maharaj, he was a grandson, and he became the leader of the demons.
而这个巴利马哈拉是 Prahlad 的孙子，他成为了恶魔的首领。
So the demigods, they're all.The main demigods, they were the children of a lady called Aditi.
而这些半神人呢，都是一位女士的儿子。这个女士的名字叫 Aditi.
There are sisters. There are many sisters, but there's two sisters in particular. One is called Diti, and the other is called Aditi.
有很多的姐妹，有两个特殊的姐妹，一个是叫 Aditi， 一个叫 Diti.
So Diti, she was the mother of the demons.
而这个 Diti 是所有恶魔的母亲。
All right, Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha, they were her children.
啊，这个 Hiranyakashipu 和Hiranyaksha 都是 Diti 的儿子。
But Aditi, she was the mother of the demigods like Indra.
而这个 Aditi 是所有半神人的母亲，比如是 Indra 的母亲。
So when the demigods got defeated, they had to go away, they had to go and hide.
所以这些恶魔半神人被击败以后，他们就得跑，就得藏起来，躲藏。
And their mother, Aditi, was missing her children.
Aditi 思念儿子心切呀。
You know, the mother very attached to their son, right?
一般母亲都依附儿子，是吧？
So they were thinking about mother Aditi's thinking about her children.
所以啊，同样 Aditi 思念她的儿子们。
So she begged her husband Kashyapa.
所以她请求她的丈夫卡西亚帕。
You have to help me.
你得帮助我呀
I miss my children.
我思念我的孩子。
So Kashyapa tried to preach to her for some time.
所以卡西亚帕呢试图向他的媳妇儿传教。
But not very easy to get through to his wife.
向妻子传教那可不是件容易事啊，忒难了，可难了。
So they told his wife anyway,If you worship the Lord, you undergo, you do a special sacrifice where you just drink milk and you worship the deity, you worship the Lord. And if you do this for a number of days, then he will be pleased with you. He can fulfill your desire.
好了，那她丈夫就爬下来说，但不管怎么着吧，你得做一些祭祀，做一些苦行去取悦他。如果你呀、只喝牛奶，喝了几天之后，你崇拜这个主后，主如果高兴了，他可能会实现你的愿望。
So Aditi did this. She followed all the instructions, and the result was she got another child. She got Lord Vamanadeva as her son.
这甭管怎么说，这个 Aditi 就遵守这个训示，他还真做了这个祭祀苦行。结果呢，这个他得到一个儿子，这个儿子就是主的化身 Vamana。
She got Lord Brahma, who's in the form of a dwarf Brahmana.
以侏儒婆罗门形象显现的。
And so he goes to Bali Maharaj, and he goes to Bali Maharaj and asks for charity.
然后他就去巴利马哈拉那里去祈求布施。
it's customary for Brahmins. Brahmanas have the right. They can go to people and ask charity.
这个 Brahmana 去人们那要布施是一种习俗啊，礼仪啊。
And they
还有权利。
They can also give charity.
所以他还能真得到布施，因为这是他权利。他可以给。哦吼。Brahmana had the right to get the donation, right?
Yeah.
And to give?
Can also give
donation. 对，这个婆罗门也有权利给别人布施，他收得到布施，他可以给布施。
They can also do other things.
他但他做以做其他的事情给布施。
They can study the scriptures.
他研婆罗门研习经典。
They can teach the scriptures.
然后教经典。
And they can worship the deity.
他婆罗门崇拜神像。
And they can teach how to worship the deity.
然后教别人怎么崇拜神像。
But Brahmanas are not supposed to work for someone.
但是婆罗门不应该替别人干活。
If they do that, then they give up their Brahman position.
如果他这么做，他就放弃了他这个婆罗门的职位了。
So Bali Maharaj had been told.By his guru, Sukracharya, give charity to the Brahmins. It's very good. You get a lot of benefit.
这个巴利玛呢也曾经得到他的 guru, Sukracharya 的训示说给婆罗门布施你将得到大大的好处。
You give them a little, you get a lot back.
你只给一点儿却能捞很多。
They have a saying in India.
在印度有一种说法，一种谚语。
They have, you know, one rupee is not very much, right?
我们知道一卢币值不了几个钱啊。
So, rupee smaller than the rupee, they have paisa.
比那个一卢币还小那个硬币叫 paisa.
A hundred paisa, one rupee, is it?
是吗？一百个 paisa 值一卢币是吗
？So they have a saying. They say.We will give one paisa, and we'll get back 100 million.
他说：“我给你一个派萨，我就得到成百上千万的卢比。”
Ek paisa dega, just like Malaga. Just like means 1 million. We will give one paisa, but get back 10 million rupees.
就那意思啊，就说我给你一派萨，我可以得到一千万的卢比回来。
There's no guarantee.
但不一定哈，不能保证。
不能保证。But Bali Maharaj had been taught you should give charity to the Brahmanas.
所以巴利玛哈也被告知给婆罗门布施。
And Bali Maharaj was very surrendered to his guru.
而巴利玛呢对他的 guru 特别臣服。
Because at one point Bali Maharaj had been killed by the demigods.
因为在一场战争中巴利玛哈也被半身人所 杀死了。
But Sukracharya, his guru, brought him back to life.
而他的 guru, Sukracharya, 竟能让他起死回生又活过来了。
So he had faith that you know, his guru is very powerful.
所以他就对他的 guru 特别有信心，他知道我的 guru 老有力量了。
So Bali Maharaj, Lord Vamanadev came to Bali Maharaj. Lord Vamanadev came begging charity.
然后这个 Vamanadev 就来找这个 Bali Maharaj 祈求布施。
He knows the.Bali Maharaj saw Brahmanas coming because he saw he was a Brahmana boy. He carried all the symbols. He had the Brahmana thread and he carried the Brahmana danda, the stick. And he came dressed in a deer skin and he could see though he's a Brahmana. And when the Brahmana comes to your house, you know, they want charity.
所以那个巴利玛一看来个小男孩，这小男孩看起来拥有这个婆罗门的所有的装饰，他带着圣线，拿着那个婆罗门的棍子，还有什么？穿着鹿皮，所以他一看这个小孩是婆罗门。一般婆罗门到他家，他马上就给布施。
Just like here in Hong Kong, sometimes we go to people's offices.
就像在香港，我们有时去人家的办公室。
So when they see.When they see us come, you know, in this dress, they know what we want.
啊，他那办公室一看，哦，穿这色衣服的人，他们知道你来干啥来了，就知道你来了目的，就是要家了，要不是。
所以于是老板不在，
所以才找个借口。The boss is absent， 老板不在啊，你们。
So Bali Maharaj saw Lord Vamanadeva come to him and he asked Bali Vamanadeva, what charity would you like?
好了，那这个我巴曼来找巴利玛呢，巴利一看就问他，你想要啥布施啊
？Charity.
And Lord Vamanadeva said, "Oh, I would like 3 steps of land."
啊，我只要三步土地的布施就够了。
But Bali Maharaj said, "Oh, no, I can give you more."
巴拉一听啊，能不能多要点儿？喜欢那么点儿。
I can give you a nice kingdom.
我会给你一个甜美的、优美的王国。
We'll give you a nice wife.
我给你们貌美贤惠的媳妇儿。
We'll give you treasure.
我给你金银珠宝。
But Lord Vamanadeva said, no, I just want 3 steps of land.
瓦曼纳，不，我只要三步就足够了。
If I cannot be satisfied with 3 steps of land, I will not be satisfied with 3 worlds.
他说，如果我三步土地都不满足的话，你给我3个世界，我也永无厌足。
But of course, the guru of Bali Maharaj, Sukracharya, was there at the time, and he was watching.
然后当时恶魔的离境导师苏库尔查亚就在场，他就傻嘛，他就观看。
And he was suspicious. Who is this Brahmana coming? I think he must be an incarnation of God.
这个咕噜就说，他就开始怀疑上了。来，这个婆罗门是谁？我肯定他是四尊人格守成的化身。
So he tells Bali Maharaj.Don't give him any charity.
然后他就告诉巴利玛人，不要给他任何的布施，一点都不给。
He might be God. If he's God, he'll take everything away from you.
他可能是神呐，你要给他，你一点都没了，全拿走了。
So Shukracharya was a materialistic kind of guru.
苏克查亚是物质主义的那个 guru.
He didn't want his disciple to become poor.
他不想让他的门徒穷困潦倒。
He wanted that, you know, his disciple should keep his wealth. He should have his power, have the kingdom.
所以他希望门徒要变得那个富有，有力量，有王国。
Because he thinks if Bali Maharaj will lose everything.Then who will take care of me?
因为他会想，如果我的门徒巴利玛他的一无所有了，谁来照顾我呀？
So he was thinking more about himself.
他想的更多的想的是自己怎么着。
So he was telling Bali Ma, don't give him charity.
所以他告诉马里玛的，别给啊，一点布施都不能给。
But Bali Maharaj was thinking, well, before he'd always told me to give charity to the Brahmanas.
完了，这个巴利玛就想，你以前总是训示我要给婆罗门布施啊。
Now he's saying, don't give any charity.
现在怎么又说不给一点布施都不给婆罗门呢？这咋回事
？And if this Brahmana boy, if he is God, then he could take everything from me.
如果这个小男孩婆罗门是神的话，他早晚都会把我的这一切都会拿走的。
And if I give him, then it will be better for me.
如果我主动给他了，对我来说岂不更好
？But if I don't give him, if he is God, he'll take it all away.
假设我不给他，如果他是神，他早晚也拿走我的一切。
So if he takes everything, then I won't get any credit.
但是我主动给他一切，我会得到好处。
But if I give it, then at least I will be, I will get the credit of giving charity.
对，如果我把他一切都给他的话，我就得到布施的所有的好处。
So he thought, I will disobey the order of my guru.
所以他想啊，就说，我得违抗、违背我姑的训示嘛。
So Shukracharya said, if you disobey my order, you will go to hell.
完了，他的姑说，如果你违背我的训示，你就得去地狱了。
Bali Maharaj was already living in hell. He was coming from there.
但是巴利玛人已经在地狱了，他就从地狱来的。
It didn't really make a big difference.
所以你诅不诅咒我都没什么区别，反正我也是在地狱来的。
Anyway, Bali Maharaj decided he would give charity.
所以巴利玛人也做出决定，我要给布施。
And then Lord Vamanadev.
给王王那对
he took one step and he covered half of the universe.
巴利王王那对一步覆盖了半个宇宙
And then he took another step and he covered the other half.
然后第二步把另一部分全给覆盖了
And then he said to Bali Maharaj, "You have cheated me."
然后他对巴利玛说，你骗了我。
You promised me three steps of land.
你答应承诺我给我三步土地。
Where am I supposed to take the third step?
我前两步都卖完没了，第三步我卖在哪儿啊
？So then Lord Vamanadev had Bali Maharaj arrested.
结果，瓦曼南派人把巴利玛人给抓起来了。
They tied him up with the ropes of Varuna.
用瓦鲁纳的绳子把他捆起来了。
So one minute, Bali Maharaj was the king of heaven, and the next minute, he had nothing. He was a prisoner.
一分钟之前，巴利玛人是整个世界的帝王。一分钟之后，一贫如洗，连王都没了。
So Prabhupada is saying in the purport, he said, "You can have everything one minute and nothing the next minute."
所以Prabhupada在要旨中说，一分钟之前你拥有一切。一分钟之后，你就是穷鬼赢一个，啥也没有。
You can be a big man worth having millions and millions of dollars one minute. Next minute, you can have nothing.
一分钟之前，你就是个大人物，拥有百万、千万个美元如币人。一分钟之后，啥都没了。
So Bali Maharaj was put into that position.
所以巴利玛赖就被置于了那种境况当中。
He surrendered.Everything to Krishna.
他巴利玛人把一切都臣服献给了 Krishna.
Right? There's nine kinds of devotional service.
有九种奉爱服是吧
？Right? So, Atmanivedanam.
Atmanivedanam
means to surrender everything.
这个意思为献出为主献出一切。
That's the most difficult kind of devotional service.
这是最难的一种奉爱服，献出一切，这是最难的奉爱服一种。
To give up everything.
放弃一切是最难的服务。
Rukmini also could do it. She also wanted to do that.
卢克米尼他就想做这种服务。
She was ready to give up everything for Krishna.
他准备放弃一切，一切都给 Krishna.
So that kind of devotional service is very, very special.
所以这种服务非常特殊。
But Bali Maharaj had made a vow to be truthful.
对于巴利玛德曾经发过誓，我一定要真诚。
So the Lord Vamanadeva was saying to him, "You told me three steps. Where am I to take the third step?"
然后这个王曼娜就对巴利曼说：“你承诺给我三步土地，第三步怎么办呢
？”To be truthful is very. You can become very powerful if you're truthful.
如果一个人真诚的话，这人特别有力量。
Maharaj Yudhisthira was very truthful.
也马哈拉尤迪斯蒂尔的特别的诚实和真诚。
The father of Lord Ramachandra, Maharaj Dasarath, he was also very truthful.
这个 Ramachandra 的父亲 Dasarath 也特别的真诚诚实。
And because they were so truthful, they became very powerful.
因为真诚，他们都特别有力量。
The more you lie and cheat the less we have power.
你越不诚实说谎，你越没有力量。
So Bali Maharaj wanted to keep his vow of being truthful.
所以巴利马赖他想信守诺言，要诚实真诚。
So when Lord Vamanadeva asked him for the third step, he said, "You can take the third step on my head."
所以这个巴姆纳就想要这个三步土第三步土地的时候，第三步的时候，巴利马说，请你把这第三步迈在我的头上。
Because you've taken the universe, you've taken all the universe in two steps, but you have not taken me.
完了说，你前两步把整个宇宙都拿走了，但你并没有拿走我本人呐。
You did not cover me, so take the third step on my head.
所以你没有覆盖过我，所以你的第三步就迈在我的头上吧。放在我的头上，第三步。
So Lord Vamanadeva took the third step on the head of Bali Maharaj.
所以Vamana 把第三步就迈在了他的头，巴利马的头上。
And he put Bali Maharaj back into the lower region of the universe. He put him back into the bottom of the universe.
然后把他派回到了这个宇宙的低等的那个区域。
And Lord Vamanadeva said, "And I'm also coming with you."
然后Vamana就说。我会和你一块儿去的。
And I will be your doorkeeper, and nobody will trouble you.
我给你看大门，我不让别人打扰你，我是你的看门人。
So in this way, Lord Vamanadeva became the servant of Bali Maharaj.
就这样 ，Vamana 成为了巴利马哈拉的仆人了。
So that's the pastime of Lord Vamanadeva.
这就是主 Vamanadeva 的逍遥时光。
Very instructive to see the greatness of a devotee like Bali Maharaj.
所以这逍遥时光特别有指导意义，看这个像巴利玛的这样的伟大的奉献者。
Although he was born in a demonic family, he was a great devotee.
虽然他出生在一个邪恶的恶魔家庭里，他仍然是一个伟大的奉献者。
And he surrendered everything.
他臣服了一切，献出一切。
Of course, Sukracharya, his guru, was not pleased with him.
当然了，他的 guru Sukracharya 对此特别不满意。
But his guru was a materialistic guru. He was not interested in his spiritual welfare.
他当然了，他这是一种物质主义的 guru， 他对这种灵性的福祉啊进步不感兴趣。
So you get.Spiritual teachers sometimes like that. Well, they're not they're gurus, but they're not really spiritual teachers. They're more materialistic teachers.
所以有的 guru 是这样的，但他这不是真正的灵性 guru， 他是只是对物质的生活方式比较感兴趣。
They just thinking only about their material benefit.
他们只是考虑着物质的得益。
So Bali Maharaj gave up that relationship.
所以巴利马呢就放弃了他那个。地位
to give everything to Krishna.
就是把一切都献给了 Krishna.
Okay. Any questions?
问题。
刚才讲到人要真诚，然后撒谎的人就会不是很好。从学习 Krishna 就觉得每次有大的节日，他不是赶在休息时间，都是撒谎，然后出来参加节日。
请假。从单位请假去参加什么规则行程，这我这是说谎了是不是？我这不是真诚是吧？我有没有力量是这意思吗？
不是，我倒不是就是这个会不会这个是可以的吗
？Well, you don't want to make a habit to do that.
但是你不要养成习惯。
The problem is once you start doing that, then it becomes a habit. You do it more and more, and you start lying in many things.
就是刚开始，就是问题就在于刚开始吧，你请你说谎，逐渐总是做，怎么做，总是这么做，将来就形成习惯了。习惯成自然了。
You have to be careful.
对此要特别的小心。
Don't make a habit to tell lies.
就是不要养成说谎的习惯。
Yes.
就是没有养成说谎的习惯，就只有在这种情况下才会。
就 only we have Jamasami Guru Purnima something.
Okay.
这可以。
还有一个问题就是，你刚才讲的巴利马尔，他很真诚，他可以向王老那献出所有的一切，但是他 陷入这三步之前的时候，他并不知道妈妈拿要想要要他所有的一切呀。那他如果他知道，他先前就知道他想要所有的一切，那他的结果呢是一样的吗？
Bali Maharaj, before he gave the charity to Vamana, he the Dada that now Vamana is the supreme personality of Godhead, right?
Well, he was told by Shukracharya that he could be the supreme.
他不知道，但他的 guru Shukracharya 告诉他了，这个小男孩有可能是神。
Yeah.
可是 guru 告诉他了。
That he could be.
他说这个可这个小男孩可能极有可能是神，他没肯定说极有可能是神。
Because they had taken over the heavenly planets and they knew that Lord Vishnu is always inclined to the demigods.
因为这个恶魔占领天堂之后，他姑姑知道这个 Vishnu 的倾向就是要帮助半神人的。
So there's always the fear from the demigods that Vishnu is going to come and help the demigods.
所以他总是恐惧担心这个 Vishnu 来帮助半神人夺回这个天堂。
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'm just curious to know, because Bali Maharaj is a great devotee. But how come he fights with the demigods? If he's a great devotee, that the supreme personality of God, then...Why he
fights with the demigods and took their kingdom? 我有一个疑惑，巴利玛拉既然是主的奉献者，为什么还攻击归神的奉献者半神人占领他们的天堂呢
？Well, he's doing his duty.
因为巴利玛拉身为恶魔，他要履行他的职责，恶魔的职责。
Just like Grandfather Bhishma's fighting Arjuna.
就像俾斯马跟阿尔朱诺作战
you know, they have a sense of duty.
他们每个人都有自己的职责，你要做的。
They're kshatriyas. They're not considering about, oh, who's a devotee, he's not the.
这个沙利利，他的职责他不会考虑啊，对方是不是奉献者啊呢？他更不考虑了，该干还得干，该履行职责履行职责，你呢？
嗯。
Guru is important.
然后那个巴利马哈拉什他的 Guru 是一个这样物质的 Guru, 他怎么会成为这么伟大的奉献者呢？
那个巴利马哈拉什 Guru is a materialistic Guru. How 巴利马哈拉什 became the so great
devotee? He had a good grandfather.
因为他有一个优秀的爷爷祖父。帕拉达玛。
Yeah. Yeah.
我有个问题，就是巴利玛哈家，他是一个很伟大的奉献者，然后他的家族也都是很伟大的奉献者，为什么会给他找一个物质主义
者做他？巴利玛哈家 is a great devotee, and her family members are also great. Why the Bali Maharaj find a materialistic guru?
Well, he's the guru of the demons.
Because his guru is the evil guru.
The gurus, you know, they have their guru. There's the guru of the demigods and there's the guru of the demons.
Because there are 半神人有半神人的 guru, 恶魔有恶魔的 guru, 他就得找这个 guru.
And not all of the family of Bali Maharaj were devotees.
而并不是巴利马哈拉整个家族的人都是奉献者，并不都是。
Some of them, Prahlad was a devotee.
有一几个人 ，Prahlad 是有点奉献者。
Why was Prahlad a devotee? Because he had association from Narada Muni.
Prahlad 为什么成为奉献者？因为他得到了 Narada Muni 的联谊 ，Narada 的联谊。
And so Bali Maharaj, he was a devotee, but there were other people in their family, the other demons, they were not devotees.
Bali Maharaj 是奉献的，他家人其他那些恶魔呢，他们不是奉献的，他们还是恶魔。
Because just like, you know, you're born in China.Right.
就像你出生在中国
Chinese are all atheists, right?
你出生在一个无神论。
It's a,
环境
an atheistic nation.
你是一个无神论的国度，对吧？
But Not everybody is atheist, right?
但不是所有人都是无神论吧？那都不是无神论。
So Bali Maharaj was born in the family of demons.
所以巴利玛呢就出生在恶魔的家庭环境中。
And because you're born in China, you had to go to a certain school, you had teachers and like that, you know.
就像你出生在中国，你上学有那里的老师。
So Bali Maharaj was born in the family of demons.
所以巴利玛呢就出生在恶魔的家庭里。
Brought up to lead the demons.
在恶魔的环境中长大成人。
我刚才想继续问，就是说，巴利马哈拉他是不是只是那一次才做了这种好像那么举业主的事情？他有没有做其他？
巴利马哈拉 only did this one thing. The other service he didn't do it.
What thing? What?He only did one
他只做了这一项服务，是吧？
是不是只做了这一次？这么说，约瑟的
巴利玛的 only do the service only this time, right? Once, not twice.
Well, he did a lot of charity to Brahmins.
他给婆罗门布施过很多次了，大量的布施。
So.You don't know who was he giving charity to.
当然，我们不知道他到底给哪个婆罗门布施了。反正他布施很多了。
Sometimes the devotees would come, maybe.
没可能有的时候奉献者婆罗门来，他就给布施。他也做。
Lord Krishna also came with Arjuna and Bhima. They dressed up as brahmanas and they came to get charity from.Jarasandha.
比如那个 Krishna, Bhima, Arjuna, 他们仨乔装改扮成婆罗门到 Jarasandha 那儿去要布施。
Because Jarasandha, he also liked to give charity to Brahmins.
所以 Jarasandha 他也喜欢给婆罗门布施，所以他是恶魔哈。
He was a big demon.
他是大恶魔呢还是
？His daughters were all married to Kamsa.
他的女儿们都嫁给康萨了，关系可好
了。So they came to see Jarasandha and they dressed up as brahmanas and begged him, please give us charity.
所以这个 Krishna Arjuna Bhima 乔装改扮成婆罗门找加尔善说，请给我们布施吧。
Because Jarasandha was looking at them and thinking, brahmanas, this Bhima, you know.
完了，加尔善一看。你们是婆罗门？你看比马长得又高又壮的，那婆罗门。
And they are speaking, you know, we want charity, you know.
而且那个他们那说话就像不像婆罗门声音，就字字有声，给我们布施。这不像婆罗门说的话。
The Brahman is a, could you give me?
你看你婆罗门说话都温文尔雅，给我布施吧。这仨人说话，给我布施。
But,Anyway, Jarasandha thought, well, anyway, they want charity, okay.
好了，我那Jarasandha，哎，不管你们是谁吧，好，要布施给。
And so then they said, yeah, we want to fight you.
我说你要什么布施？我们仨想跟你战斗，我们想跟你打架，给我这个布施。
And Jarasandha looked at them and said, ah, Krishna, oh, I'm not going to fight you.
完了，加他一看，哦 ，Krishna， 你是 Krishna， 我可不跟你玩，我不跟你打。
You ran away in the battle last time I fought.
上次我跟你打的时候，你从头之夭夭从战场上逃窜了，你不跟你打。
And I'm not going to fight you, Arjuna. You're weak. You're not strong enough. You won't give me a good fight.
好了，那他看 Arjuna， 我不跟你打 Arjuna， 你太弱，跟我比你小菜一碟，我不跟你打。
I'll fight you, Bhima.
Bhima， 我要跟你玩一玩。
You look like you can give me a good.
你适合跟我作战 ，Arjuna 力量没我足，我就跟你打。
So they had a great fight.
所以 Bhima 和加尔善他有一场大战。
And Krishna had to help Bhima.
然后 Krishna 帮助了 Bhima，
he was able to rip Jarasandha，
完了把 Jarasandha 一劈两半
，right down the middle，
从中间劈开一劈两半
So charity, you know, you give charity, when you give charity to Krishna, to the devotee like Prabhupada, then it can come back an unlimited number of times.
如果你给 Krishna 布施或者给 Papa 布施，你的回报是无限量的回报。
When you give charity to an ordinary person, it will come back an equal amount.
如果你给普通人布施的话，布施多少回多少，平等，等量。
When you give charity to the brahmana, it will come back many times.
而给婆罗门布施，成百倍、很多倍的回来。
But if you give charity to the pure devotee like Prabhupada, then it will come back unlimited.
如果你给纯粹奉献者像帕帕这样的人布施的话，你回报的是无限。
这回报是什么？
这样，这个回报是指什么？Unlimited return. What does that mean? Repaying.
Well.Depends on your desire, right?
取决你布施的愿望是啥。
There's different kinds of charity.
有不同种类的布施。
Charity in the mode of ignorance.
也有愚昧形态的布施。
You give charity to a drug addict. If you give to a drug addict or a drunkard, you give him money. You give money to somebody who's a drunkard, who's
如果你给那些酒鬼啊、烟鬼布施的话，是愚昧形态的，给他们布施。
And if you give charity to get name and fame, that's passion.
如果你给布施是为了自己的名声和名望，这是激情形态的布施。
You know, if you give charity, we'll put your name up here that you.
哦，我给你布施，把我的名字给我刻上。
But charity in the mode of goodness, you do it without not telling anybody.
善良形态的布施，给布施以后不留名，不跟别人说，悄悄的。
And you give it for the service of Krishna.
然后给的这个布施是为了服务 Krishna 用，善良形态。
That's the highest charity.
这是最高的布施。
Purpose, yeah. What's the purpose in giving charity?
Yeah.
Well, I said it's different for different people.
不同的人应该有不同的目的给布施。
We want to make advancement in Krishna consciousness.
我们的目的是想在 Krishna 自由中进步，怀着这个目的，你给布施。
The best charity you can give the holy name.
最好的布施是给圣名，这是最佳的布施。
We go for Sankirtan.
你去做 Sankirtan.
Maybe this weekend we can go.
可能这个周末我们就出去 Sankirtan 去了。
Go on the promenade here.
啊？
On the promenade along beside that path around the sea.
我们要开啊，我们就绕着这个湖边海洋的去Kirtan，这个周末。
Usually, many people come from China.
因为这个时候通常有很多中国人来，哎，来的。
Give them the holy name.
给他们圣名。
That's the highest charity.
这是最高的布施。
Yes, Jeremiah.
The Brahmana cannot work for the others. What does that mean? What's it refer to?
Means Brahmana is supposed to do work like worshipping the deity.
这个婆罗门干的活应该是崇拜神像。
Or teaching people to worship.
然后教导教别人崇拜神像。
Or he studies the scriptures.
然后是研习经典。
And he teaches the scriptures.
教授别人经典。
But he doesn't want to go and take a job in the office.
啊，不是说到办公室去上班去工作的。这不是。
That's Brahmana means one who is on the path to Brahman. He's cultivating the spiritual path.
他博尔蒙指的是踏上这个梵的这个路径，是也研习梵、培养梵的这个的道路的，走是走这条路的。
Brahmana is supposed to be like the head in the body.
婆罗门好比这个身体上的头、脑袋。
But if he works in the job, then he becomes a servant of the boss in the company.
如果你上班，婆罗门干上班的工作，就意味着你是这个公司老板的仆人。
So then, you see, the mostly Brahmanas.They were meant to be worshipping the deity, but they give up that work. They go and take a job in the office.
这个婆罗门原本的职责是应该在这个庙崇拜神像，现在他们都放弃了，他们都到单位去上班去了。
They think I'll make more money.
是为了挣更多的钱，来点钱。
So they give up their Brahminical qualities.
所以他们放弃了婆罗门的品质。
And become Sudras.
成为了苏卓。
Work in the job.
在上班工作去了，输着的活这是。
But Brahman is not meant to work for other people.
所以婆罗门是原本是不应该替别人干活的，工作的。
He's meant to be independent.
他是应该是独立的。
Okay.
在这个年代我们做不到婆罗门做不到这
儿。Yeah, we say Kalo, in the Kali Yuga, everybody is Sudra.
所以说卡利年代人人出生都是苏卓。
You go to university, become a Sudra.
你上大学就是为了成为一个优秀的苏卓。
应该。
这个年代还是有的，就说是极少。
Yeah, our Krishna consciousness movement is especially meant for creating some Brahmanas.
所以 Krishna 知觉运动有时就意味着创造婆罗门，发展婆罗门。
But also, there are many people working in the jobs.They are also very advanced devotees.
但是在单位办公室上班的那奉献者，他也是很进步的奉献者。
Prabhupada writes in the Bhagavad Gita, he said some people are working in the job or in the factory, but they give the result of their work, the fruit of their work, they give it all for Krishna.
那个泡泡在《薄伽梵歌》中说到，那有的奉献者在办公室工厂工作。但他们把这个活动的结果都献给了 Krishna.
So he said they're really in the renounced order of life.
所以泡泡说这些人都是真正的生命的弃绝阶段的人。
Because they're giving everything to Krishna.
因为他把一切都给 Krishna 了。
So they may be working, they may be in the job, but they're not attached.
对，也许他们在那工作，但他们不依附。
But if you're working in the job just for your own comfort, then that is not very good.
如果你上班只是为了自己去上班，这不太好。
Well, we don't really know. She's saying, no. Did you understand?
Yeah, I understand. Because we are broadcasting, and also some devotees, they don't understand Chinese.
And so, did Bali Maharaj become a pure devotee when he had to give up everything? that previously he was asking, he was giving charity to get some material benefit. But I don't really know that if that's true, that Bali Maharaj was giving charity just to get material benefit.
这个我还真的不知道，巴利玛拉的该给布施，纯粹是为了他物质的得益，这个不知道。
But his guru had told him, give charity to the Brahman.
但是他的 guru 告诉他要给 Brahman 的婆罗门布施。
So he was obedient to his guru up to that point. He was obedient. He was following the order.
Yeah, 他就那起初是追随他 guru 的。
But when his guru told him, don't give this Brahmana.Then he had a doubt. What's why?
而当他的 guru 告他不要给这个婆罗门布施主，他就起了怀疑了。
嗯 ，certainly he was put in the position. He had given up everything. He'd seen everything taken away from him. So he surrendered. He did not have any regret about it.
当他所有的一切都被拿走以后，我们看出巴利玛的并没有为此而后悔，他没后悔。
He was taken a prisoner. He was put into a humiliating position.
所以他成为了囚犯了，这些他使他让他自己处在一个特别谦卑的卑微的一个境界中。
And his family were all there, and they were looking at him.
他家人当时可全在场啊，看着他那么悲惨。
And then Prahlad Maharaj also came there.
啊 ，Prahlad Maharaj 他也来了，就看着他。
Prahlad Maharaj pleaded on behalf of Bali Maharaj.
所以 Prahlad Maharaj 代表着 Bali Maharaj 向主祈求。
And spoke to Lord Vamanadeva to be merciful to him.
向Vamanadeva 说，请给 Bali Maharaj 仁慈吧。
So the association was very important.
所以联谊特别重要。和谁联谊特别重要。
你刚才讲到一个婆罗门，他的侄子，那个拉什曼帕布，他就在北京做神像礼拜的服务嘛。然后他交养老金的时候，他就没有钱了，都是他的妻子给他交钱。但是也因此，他可能也会受到一点点，就是他的妻子就说
打扰。
But this is talking of one devotee in Beijing. He's from Mudanjiang, so he's in Beijing helping in the ashram there. And so he does Brahminical work, worships a deity and cooks some things. So he doesn't get paid very much, right?
Yes.
So it's difficult for him, right? Because there's not a lot of financial remuneration. You don't get much in return, a very low salary. But a Brahmana doesn't worry about that.
但是婆罗门 Brahmana 不应该为此忧心忡忡。
Brahmana, one of the qualities of a Brahmana is that he is satisfied in whatever position he is in.
那个 Brahmana 有一个优秀品质，就是无论身处何境，都感到心满意足，小富即安，没富他也即安，这是婆罗门的品质。
Just like in Mayapur, we have a lot of brahmacharis there in Mayapur.
就像在玛雅坡，我们有大量的真守生 brahmachari.
And they get 500 rupees a month.
一个月只给五到十卢币。
五百。
哦，错收了，五百 one 番茄。
五百呀。
五百卢币，都一千。
500 rupees, you know, there's 80 rupees in $1.80卢比是一个美金。
80卢比一个美金，500卢比多少美金
？It's not a lot of money.
就说吧，这一个月给500卢比，这个工资不高。
But you don't worry about it.
但他们也不为此那么焦虑。
You don't think, oh, I'm not getting much. Yeah, If you're thinking like that, if you're worried about the money, then you're not a Brahmin.
所以他们不会说，哎呀，只给这点钱。如果一个婆罗门想给我这么点儿，他不是真正的婆罗门。如果这么想，本身就不是真正的 Brahmin。
Brahmin is not worried about how much he gets.
Brahmin 呢，婆罗门根本就不在乎每月给多少钱。
But whatever he gets, he's going to use it for Krishna.
无论他得到什么，都拿去服务 Krishna， 这就是婆罗门。他每个月要交多少？
每年
交一万。This Brahman 呢，should pay 的一万多少钱？
一万人民币。
He's supposed to pay money every year for his pension to get a pension when he's old.
So he doesn't have.
So he doesn't have money to pay all that.
Yeah. That's a good question.
No, it's not a problem.
这也不是个什么问题。我咕噜说了，这也不是问题，咕噜知道了。我们都不工作，我们也没钱，这也不是问题。
I hear what they said. I think it's their problem, not the
Brahmins.
我想
我们要结束了，9:15
已经
到了。
9:00。
OK. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Srimad Bhagavatam. Ki Jai.